Hey, Satch, how you doing, buddy? I didn't expect to see you. I figured you'd be watching Dropkick Murphys tonight. Hi, Joan. Hope everybody had a good week. I'm glad to say I did. Got a lot of work done outside this week. Edie had a bunch of days off. She had pretty much this whole week off, so it was wonderful having her home. So she did a lot of work inside, outside. We worked together on a bunch of stuff, so it was a lot of it was different. It was nice because she also tested negative, so we've been able to actually be next to each other and not have to worry about having masks and you know. It's actually been nice. It's been like normal in the house. So that was a great thing. Who else? Satch is watching the other channel. I figured you would be. And Bobby's on. Hey, Mike, how's it going? I figured I'd just give it a couple minutes for people to start catching up. So I think we're going to get started. And who else? Dave Keenan. Hey, Dave. Thanks for joining us every week. I haven't seen you in a while. I found something when I was thinking about you the other day. I'm starting to get this streak on both sides. And I started thinking years ago about when you started to get your streak. And I thought, wow, I'm turning into Dave Keenan. So it's a good thing, right? So I'm glad you're joining us every week. It's looking forward to seeing you in real life. All right, well, we're gonna get started. And once again, the only rules are: if you know the song, sing it with me. If you don't know the song, hum it. Almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountain, Shenandoah. Life is older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze. Country road, take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, mountain mama, take me home. Country road, all my memories around her, miner's lady, stranger to blue water, dark and dusty, painted on the sky, misty taste of moonshine, teardrop in my country road, take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, yesterday, country road, take me home to the place I belong, West Virginia. Denver. He was a great artist. I always loved his stuff back then. Could never sing as high as him. So I have to do things down a few keys, but I did this song the other a couple weeks ago. I don't know if I did it last week. I don't even remember. But I like this song, and it reminds me of my dad, so I'm doing it again. Actually, I did it the one week, and I told the story about my dad. And I don't think I told the story correctly. Like my dad used to tell stories. He always said, so this is a Tom Jones song, and I thought I said that, but he always said, Engelbert, what's his dink? He loved this song because of Engelbert, what's his dink? Humperdinck. So, but I whenever I hear this song, I think of my dad, so that's why I like to play it. So. I saw the light of the night that I passed by her window. I saw the flickering shadows of love on the blind. She was my woman, and as she deceived me, I watched and went out of my mind. My Delilah, why Delilah? I could see that girl was no good for me, but I was lost like a slave that no man could free. At break of day, when the man drove away, I was waiting. I crossed the street to her house, and she opened the door. She stood there laughing. I felt the knife in my hand, and she laughed no more. My Delilah, why Delilah? So before they come and break down the door, give me Delilah, I just couldn't take anymore. Delilah, I just couldn't take any more. Yeah, Engelbert, what's his dick? Actually, Tom Jones. But and my capo dislodged as I was playing. What capo is that, Eve? The Thalia. The very expensive. I love that capo. It really holds on okay if you get the right thing, but it tends, you hit it a little bit and awesome. Boop. Oh, well. So, it's another week. I want to say thanks for joining us again, everybody. It's a pleasure to be here for me. I know there's a bunch of people up in Boston playing tonight, and I know they're interfering with some of our people, but that's okay. Satch, you're still here. It's great. Oh, Father Brian's here too. Father Brian Cullinane, thanks for coming. I know Dropkick Murphy and Dropkick Murphy's and Springsteen on the same bill. That's something. That's all right. That's okay. You know what? If you're going to make a donation, make a donation. That's a good thing. And we're trying to do that too. We're trying to make people happy. We're trying to get us all through this and be as normal as possible. So here's to everybody that's joining us, those people that are not joining us, that have joined us, and that we're getting through this thing together. We love you all, and we look forward to seeing you live. Tonight, if you see in the back over here, I don't know if you can see it, but I decided to go with a little bit of a straw Chianti. No fava beans.
Well, the south side of Chicago is the baddest part of town. you go down there, you better just beware of a man named Leroy Brown. Well, Leroy, Martin Trouble, you know we stand about 6 foot four. All the downtown ladies call him Tree Tower Lover, all the men just call him Sir. And he's bad, bad, Leroy Brown, bad as man in a whole damn town, badder than old King Kong, and he's a man in a junkyard dog. Friday, out of week, kiddie, oh, Leroy, shooting dice. And at the edge of the bar sat a girl named Doris, and who that girl, she looked nice. Well, it cast its eyes upon her, and trouble soon began. And Leroy Brown, he learned a lesson about missing the wife of a jealous man. And he's bad, bad, Leroy Brown, bad as man. Saw a puzzle with a couple of pieces gone. And he's bad, bad, Leroy Brown, baddest man in a whole damn town, badder than old King Kong, and meaner than a junkyard dog. Yeah, he was badder than old King Kong, and meaner than a junkyard dog.
Little Jim Croce. I remember that song going up to Lake Apatcon with my kid, with my dad. I was a kid, and I'd be in the car with my mom and dad going up to Lake Apatcon to visit some cousins and go to the boat and that kind of thing. And I remember sitting in loads of traffic. It was before Route 80 was through New Jersey, so we'd have to get off and get onto 46 and back roads. Oh, it took hours to do what's now is a 40, 45 minute drive. Wow. A song I wrote because of some friends and my parents too. So, wow, I'm just looking. We're getting a storm moving in, so hopefully we stay on tonight with electricity and all, because I'm seeing a lot of wind and some major clouds moving in. So,
oh my goodness.
Looks bad, right? So.
I heard a baby crying in the middle of the night. His mother gently rocked him under the rays of heaven light. She sang a song to comfort him and made the bad things go away. She tenderly caressed his head, and this is what I heard her say. Hold on to memories, but forget about the past. Look toward tomorrow, for today it just can't last. And like the waves rolling in from the sea, I hold on to you, I hold on to you, I hold on to you, if you just hold on.
I lost a friend a few years ago. He was such a good friend to me.
I loved him like a brother, and he was just like family.
I cried the day we buried him. Emotion broke me apart.
And then I heard that song again, echoing in my heart and singing, hold on to memories, but forget about the past. Look toward tomorrow, for today it just can't last. And like the waves rolling in from the sea, I hold on to you, I hold on to you, I hold on to you, maybe just hold on.
Not alone again. I'm trying
choking back the tears. And then I heard my mother's voice singing songs through all those years. Her voice is filled with confidence, her voice is from the heart. I joined her singing and I begin to make a fresh new start by singing, hold on to memories, but forget about the past. Look for tomorrow, for today it just can't last. And like the waves rolling in from the sea, I hold on to you, I hold on to you, I hold on to you, if you just hold on to me. I hold on to you, I hold on to you, I hold on to you, if you just hold on to me.
Hold on to you. I need a little sip of wine for this song. I hear that train a-comin', it's rolling round the bend. I ain't seen sunshine since I don't know when. I'm stuck in Folsom Prison, and the time keeps dragging on. That train keeps rolling on down to San Antone. When I was just a baby, my mama told me, son, always be a good boy and don't ever play with guns. Well, I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die. When I hear that whistle blowing, I hang my head and I cry. Dining car, you're probably drinking whiskey and smoking big cigars. Well, I know I had it coming, I know I can't be free. But those people keep on moving, and that's what tortures me. If they freed me from this prison, if that railroad train was mine, you know I'd move the whole thing a little further down the line, away from Folsom Prison. That's where I'd want to stay. And I'd let that lonesome whistle blow my blues away. Yeah, I'd let that lonesome whistle blow my blues away. Headed up to San Francisco for the Labor Day weekend show. I got my hush puppies on, I guess I never went in for glitter rock and roll. Honey, I didn't know that I'd be missing you so. Come Monday, it'll be alright. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in a brown L.A. I just want you back by my side.
something to try to explain. Now, honey, it's I love you so. That's the reason I just let you go. Come Monday, it'll be alright. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I've spent four lonely days in a brown LA haze, and I just want you back by my side. I can't help it, honey, you're just that much a part of me now. Remember that night in Montana when we said there'd be no room for doubt? I hope you're enjoying the scenery. I know that it's pretty up there. We can go hiking on Tuesday. With you, I'd walk anywhere. California has worn me quite thin. I just can't wait to see you again. Come Monday, it'll be alright. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in a brown LA haze, and I just want you back by my side. I spent four lonely days in a brown LA haze, I just want you back by my side.
Let's see.
I can't begin to know him, but then I know it's growing strong. Was in the spring, then spring became summer. Who'd have believed you'd come along? Touching hands, reaching out, touching me, touching you. Sweet Caroline, good times never seem so good.
So good, so good, so good.
I believe they never would.
washing hands version this time. I figured we'd do the real version. So it's nice to do the real one for a change, huh? And since there's so many people up in Boston to listen to music, I figure let's bring some Boston music here to New Jersey and spread it back out to Boston for all those guys up there. So, and here's another one.
Riding roads and get on hold.
How you have to end them. I'm getting a little sweat in my eyes. I put the air conditioner. We don't have central air in our house. And it's been beautiful, and we've had windows open, and it started to get hotter and more humid. And today, it was like unbelievably humid. It was just oppressively humid. So that was it. Pulled out the air conditioners and stuck them in the windows, and it's a little better in here tonight. So, let's see what other songs we have here tonight. Let's see. Where are we? Oh, I see. Okay.
I saw you just the other day at the mall. The way your looking jeans could make my heart stall. But baby, you got what it takes. Yeah, yeah. There ain't no use complaining. No, no, you got what it takes. The way that cotton dress falls around you, the way the sunlight streams right through. Now baby, you got what it takes. Yeah, yeah. There ain't no use complaining, no, no, you got what it takes. The way you pucker those big red lips, it's the way you swing those hips. Now, baby, you got what it takes. Yeah, yeah. There ain't no use complaining.
wink at me as you were walking by. You didn't stop a second, cause you were on the fly. Cause baby, you got what it takes. There ain't no use complaining. Nah, nah, you got what it takes. When I finally got the nerve to talk to you, you said, I'm sorry, chump, but you just won't do. Cause you see, baby, you ain't got what it takes. You told me fortune and fame, yeah, yeah, that's what it takes. Well, let me tell you something, I ain't got no wallet full of cash, and I ain't no rock star with sparkles and flash, but baby, I got what it takes. Cause I knows what I'm packing, sugar, ooh, I got what it takes. Ha ha, let me show ya. Ever since I piqued your curiosity, I got no solitude, you won't let me be. Cause baby, you want what it takes. You don't hear me complaining. Nah, nah, you get what it takes. The secret of the world, if you promise not to tell, you can't get water if you don't go to the well. So baby, start pumping. There ain't no use complaining. Nah, nah, come get what it takes. The moral of my story and the end of my rhyme, the grass is greener on the other side. So baby, you got what it takes. Yeah, yeah. Complain, complain, complain. You got what it takes. Was You Got What It Takes. I wrote that song a whole bunch of years ago, and I just think it's a fun song. It's a little different than the song that just was released this week. I'm going to be gratuitous, how do you say that word? Gratuitously plugging right now. A song I wrote that I told you guys about last week, Other Side of Tomorrow, that I wrote and dedicated to the graduating class of 2020. I had put it up on YouTube, and now it is up on YouTube officially, excuse me, officially on YouTube, and also Amazon Music, Spotify, Apple Music, Pandora, I think there's a whole bunch of them. So it's pretty cool that I got some of that, my stuff is out there. So if you're interested, look up Vic Spinelli, Other Side of Tomorrow, and absolutely download it if you'd like. I would appreciate it. Let's see, where are we? Oh, I see where we are. I'm gonna put a capo on for this one. Just because I like the sound of the guitar with this. I've heard there was a secret chord that David played, and it pleased the Lord. You don't really care for music, do you? It goes like this: the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, and the major lift. The baffled king composing hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw
her bathing on the roof, her beauty in the moonlight overthrew you. She tied you to a kitchen chair, she broke your throne and she cut your hair, and from your lips she drew the hallelujah. Hallelujah.
About ready to sneeze about 18 times. Not that you care about that, but okay. Another Jimmy Buffett song. Probably his most famous. Nibbling on sponge cake. Watching the sun, baby, and all those Tories covered with oil. Strumming my sixth string on my front porch swing. Smell them trains, they're beginning to boil. Wasted away again in Margaritaville, searching for my lost sugar soul. Some people claim that they're the one to blame, but I know it's nobody's fault. I don't know the reason I stayed here all season. Nothing is sure but this brand new tattoo, but it's a real beauty, a Mexican cutie. And how I got here, I haven't a clue. Oh, wasted away again in Margaritaville,
searching for my lost share of thought. Some people claim that they're the one to blame, but I know it could be my fault.
Hey, this one's for Satch. A lost verse.
Old men in tank tops, cruising the gift shops, checking out Chiquitas down by the shore. They dream about weight loss, wish they could be their own boss. Those 3-day vacations become such a bore. But I blew out my flip-flop, stepped on a pop-top. I cut my heel, had to cruise on back home. But there's booze in the blender, and soon it will render that frozen concoction that helps me hang on. Oh, wasted away again in Margaritaville, searching for my lost sugar soul. Some people claim that they're the one to blame, but I know it's my own damn fault. I'm snacking on Cheetos, sometimes Doritos. I'm stuck in my house, I got no place to go.
But that's starting to change.
Not caring how I look,
sip on live on Facebook.
Just me and the sun, and we're both sinking low. Wasted away again in Quarantine. All I can think of to do is just yawn. And I heard it said that no one's got any bread, and I've been told all that TP is gone. They say it's contagious, and we must be courageous, hang out at home till this danger is past. They say it's our duty to shelter our booty. I'm trying my best, but it's only half-assed. Whoa, wasted away again in Quarantineville, struggling with my withdraw from sports. Baseball is out, the whole season's in doubt. Like a sacrificed fly, right at my shorts. I'm washing my hands well, and stocked up on Purell. Vacuumed up every square inch of my house. But there's booze in the icebox.
This ain't time for detox.
If I'm socially distanced, might as well do it soused. Wasted away again in Quarantineville, doing my best to not lose my mind. Keeping real clean and wiping things down in between, till that day we're no longer confined. Oh, keeping real clean and wiping things down in between, till that day we're no longer confined. Thank you.
Yeah, a little Quarantineville after the Margaritaville song. You know what? Things are starting to move along. We're starting to get the first phase of opening here in New Jersey. I don't know what's going on in other states. I think we're all starting to get there. We've all been itching to do that, but we still have to be safe. I know a lot of it's because of the economy, but we still have to be careful because that virus is not taking a break. It's going to still be out there. So continue to do your social distancing and taking your precautions. And yeah, we need to start trying to get back to a normal life at some point, but you know that the numbers are starting to flatten out. But we still need to be socially responsible for each other. So I just hope everybody takes that as a word and takes it to heart. I'm going to do a song now that I found out means a lot to somebody here that's been watching. Because apparently it goes back to having her daughters who are grown now, and now she has grandchildren, but she used to sit on a backyard swing with her daughters and swing together and sing this song together. So Linda Stanton, you said you really loved this song, so I'm gonna play it again for you and your girls tonight.
Next time you're found with your chin on the ground, there's a lot to be learned, so look around. Just what makes that little old man think he'll move a rubber tree plant? Anyone knows an ant can move a rubber tree plant, but he's got high hopes. He's got high hopes. He's got high apple pie in the sky hopes. So anytime you're getting low, instead of letting go, just remember that ant. And oops, there goes another rubber tree. Oops, there goes another rubber tree. Oops, there goes another rubber tree plant. When trouble's cold and your back's to the wall, there's a lot to be learned. That wall could fall. Once there was a silly old ram, thought he punched a hole in the dam. No one could make that ram scram. He kept butting that dam, cause he had high hopes. He had high hopes. He had high apple pie in the sky. So anytime you're feeling bad, instead of feeling sad, just remember that ram. And oops, there goes a billion kilowatt. Oops, there goes a billion kilowatt. Oops, there goes a billion kilowatt dam. Just the toy balloon, they'll be bursted soon. They're just bound to go pop. Oops, there goes another problem purr. Oops, there goes another problem purr. Oops, there goes another problem purr. Plop.
Kerr plop. I love that song. I'm going to put this aside. 1 second there. Edie is just itching to get here. I'm going to put this down. I see it. I'm going to put this down, put this over here. I'm going to let Edie in. Look at this. We are next to each other.
So this is what happens when you do your part and you social distance. Those of us that work at the hospital that turn up negative, we can hug our family. So it's been a great week.
Let me move. I'm taking my wine.
Okay. Happy Friday, everybody. So, some more good news from Hackensack University Medical Center. We're down to 89 COVID positive patients. And as I've said in the past weeks, we had a peak of 500. So that's just an amazing number. And we're so happy that that trend is going down. Everybody at the hospital needs a break. All across the state of New Jersey, you know, we've been hit really hard. So keep doing what you're doing. We all thank you from the bottom of our hearts. I got to hug my grandkids today for the first, not today, this week, for the first time in 2 months. Because unfortunately, Vic and I know many, many friends and family that have either been positive or have unfortunately passed away. So we aren't taking any chances. But because I tested negative and I was actually off all week, so I didn't go into work and I haven't been anywhere, I was able to smush those kids. And I know Lucas and Alexis at the end were like, stop hugging me. And then Vicky reminded me I was so happy I was hugging the kids. I never hugged her. So sorry, Vic. But then I did afterwards. Some other good things, 60 Minutes this weekend on Sunday is going to feature Hackensack University Medical Center and some of the plasma therapy that we're doing there. So it's a good thing. If you can't watch it, set your DVR because we are doing wonderful things at the hospital. I'm very proud to work there. So watch 60 Minutes this week. Notice my Mets hat. Probably for the first time in about 20 years, my bangs are so long, I have to tuck them back, and I think I might do a no bangs thing. So in the meantime, I get to wear my favorite Mets hat. When we are able to open, make sure you go back, support your salons. I know they've been really struggling, but we just have to make sure that everybody's safe before we open up to the next phases in our state. Tonight we had dinner from Sage. You know that's one of our favorite restaurants, so if you are looking to have some food, if you're local, if you're in the Fairlawn area, it's an amazing restaurant. We had our Thai calamari. The only thing I miss more than Thai calamari is Linda Calamari Stanton. So Linda, I can't wait till we can get together again and have some Thai calamari together. So those of you that don't know, my friend Linda's maiden name is actually calamari. Check out the chalk art on Instagram and Facebook. My very talented son-in-law, Frank, is continuing to do chalk art. This week, since our granddaughter, Alexis, is a fifth grade graduate, Frank went to their school and did a whole chalk art in front of the school to congratulate those graduates. So it was just such a great feeling. And that's when I found out when I was negative, when I went over to look at the chalk art and he was drawing. And the kids were there, and that's when I got the email that I was negative. So it was a scene in the middle of Gilbert Avenue in Elmwood Park. But that's okay, because I'm a grandma. So my Breezy got me this really cool Vera Bradley mask. So I can begin my career as a ventriloquist, because nobody sees your mouth, right? And I have a very special unicorn here. And this unicorn is to wish Lizzie Scazzeri a very happy fourth birthday this week. Lizzie and her brother Brendan watch Quarantunes every week on their big TV, and they have a dance party. And their dad, Mike, sends us videos of the kids doing their dance party, and it's Lizzie's birthday. So Lizzie, I heard you really like unicorns, so I just wanted to make sure that you had a special happy birthday from our happy birthday unicorn. Oh yeah, I was supposed to make a talk since I'm a ventriloquist now. All right, so other birthdays. So today, my longtime friend since high school, Scott Goodman, it's his birthday. May 31st, another very, very long time, two very, very long time friends, Jimmy Kramer and Dee Gersten, who have been my friends since first grade. So it's their 60th birthday on the 31st, so happy, happy birthday. I know this is really not how we all planned on spending our 60th birthdays this year, but I hope you have a great day. On June 3rd, we have our friends Bob Colon, and we have Kevin's best friend since he was 8 years old, Joe Molitoris. And if you remember last year, we went to Hungary to attend Joe and Lily's wedding. So happy birthday, Joe. We also have some really special anniversaries this week. So Lizzie's mom and dad are celebrating their 9th anniversary on the 4th. And one of Vicky's very good friends, who was also her friend through St. Leo's Grammar School and was her college roommate, Bethany Sotsky and Matt Agrati, they're married 10 years this year. And next Friday, we'll be celebrating a very special anniversary. It's actually mine and Vic's anniversary for 38 years next Friday. So we'll talk about that next week. So just remember to hug everyone. Something I was thinking about, the quarantine and the pandemic has really been a reset button for a lot of us. And I know a lot of my cousins are watching. So I've been thinking a lot about Grandma this week and about the previous pandemic that happened in 1918. And Vic and I were talking at dinner tonight about both of our grandmothers. Now, before I was married, we lived in a house, it was a two-family house, and my cousins Bobby and Marianne lived on the other side of our two-family house. And we all had the amazing opportunity that we lived with Grandma. We had her every single day. And I thought about her a lot because I took some statistics down. So she had babies in 1914, 1915, 1917, 1918, and 1920. So she had 5 little children in the middle of that pandemic. Vic's mom was born in 1919, so she was born right in the middle of that pandemic. They had no TV, they had no social media. They had to wear masks. And think about the dress in 1918. Those were those long dresses, and they didn't have electric washing machines and dishwashers. So it made me really think about what an incredible woman my grandmother was, what an incredible woman Vic's grandmother was, to get through those hard times. And then they went through the Depression, and then they went through World War II, and both of our grandmothers lost their youngest sons in World War II. So if those amazing, strong women can get through those kind of tribulations, we can certainly do our part to get through this pandemic. So I just want to put things into perspective, and I want to leave you with a very important quote from my favorite poet, Maya Angelou. And if you saw on Facebook this week, I posted a picture from a few years ago when Vic actually had the privilege to sit with Maya Angelou in her living room in Harlem when he was working at CNN. So Maya wrote, "Apologizing does not always mean that you're wrong and the other person is right. It just means you value your relationship more than your ego. This has never been more poignant than right now." So as I always say every week, be smart, be safe, be well, and most of all, be kind. Have a great week. We look forward to seeing you next Friday. And now back to Vic.
Well, that's going to be tough to come back and get past here, to follow. Tough to follow. But you know what? I'm going to do exactly what Edie said. You said you ended up right to be wine.
Be wine, yes.
Be wine or be kind. It's be kind. I got it wrong. I'm going to be kind. I'm going to be kind to my wine. Thank you, Edie. Happy birthday to everybody. I should tune up again because just to make sure everything's holding. No? Yeah, pretty good. See, yep, tonight, last week, if you remember, everything was all over the place. Tonight, it's holding tune with no problem, so that's a good thing. Let's see. I think I'm going to sing happy birthday to Lizzie, because Lizzie's 4 years old already. So I'm going to sing. Let's all sing to Lizzie. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Lizzie. Happy birthday to you.
happy birthday to everyone else out there, too, that's celebrating a birthday this week. Okay, I gotta get my pedal. Got kicked away from me. Let's give this a shot. Well, talking about being kind to my wine. It's 9 o'clock and that old clock's been moving slow, and so am I. Workday passes like molasses in the wintertime. Oh, but it's July. I get paid by the hour and older by the minute. The boss just put me over the limit. I want to call him something. I think I'll just call it a day. Pour me something tall and strong. Make it a hurricane before I go insane. It's only 12:30, but I don't care. Pour me something tall and strong. Make it a hurricane before I go insane. It's only 12:30, but I don't care. It's 5 o'clock somewhere. Well, this lunch break is gonna take all afternoon and half the night. Tomorrow I know that there will be hell to pay. Oh, but that's alright. I ain't had a day off in over a year. My Jamaican vacation's gonna start right here. If that phone is for me, just tell him I just sailed away. Pour me something tall and strong. Make it a hurricane before I go insane. It's only 12:30, but I don't care. Pour me something tall and strong. Make it a hurricane before I go insane. It's only 12:30, but I don't care. It's 5 o'clock somewhere. I can pay off my tab, pour myself in a cab, and be back to work before two. At a moment like this, I can't help but wonder, what would Jimmy Buffett do? I think he'd pour us all a drink and have us party. Pour me something tall and strong. Make it a hurricane before I go insane. It's only 12:30, but I don't care. Pour me something tall and strong. Make it a hurricane before I go insane. It's only 12:30, but I don't care. I don't care. It's 5 o'clock somewhere. O'clock somewhere. You know, Edie was talking about Maya Angelou being her favorite poet, and you know, I always listen. I've listened to her and I've read some of her stuff. And before I met her, I wasn't really a huge fan. You know, it was just not something that, you know, I really thought about. I met that woman that day, and she was just so kind and so nice. And I got to tell you, I was late getting home that day, and Edie and I had plans to go out for dinner that night, and I was supposed to be out early, and it turned out I went late, and part of that was because I really enjoyed the day, and I stayed there, and I finished out the job instead of getting swapped out, and I called her on the way home, and I said to her, now she said, next week is our anniversary, it's 38 years, and I called her, and I said, I just want to let you know, I'm sorry I was so late, but I met a woman tonight, and I think she was 80 at the time, in her 80s. And I said, I think I fell in love with another woman today. The woman was just incredible. She just had a wonderful soul, a wonderful spirit. And I feel so blessed to have met her. But yeah, there's been a lot of quotes, especially recently, that I've read that really, it really, she was way,
way ahead of her time. Anyway, back to partying.
Your mama don't dance and your daddy don't rock and roll. Your mama don't dance and your daddy don't rock and roll. When evening rolls around, it's time to go to town. Where do you go? To rock and roll. The old folks say that you're gonna end your day by 10. You're out on a date, you bring it home late, it's a sin. Just ain't no excuse, and you know you're gonna lose and never win. I'll say it again. Your mama don't dance and your daddy don't rock and roll. Your mama don't dance and your daddy don't rock and roll. When evening rolls around, it's time to go to town. Where do you go? To rock and roll. Drive and find a place to park. You hop into the backseat when you know it's nice and dark. You're just about to groove and you're thinking it's a breeze. A light in your eye and a guy says out of the car, long hamburger. You're coming with me, the local police. And it's all because your mama don't dance and your daddy don't rock and roll. Your mama don't dance and your daddy don't rock and roll. You pull into a drive and find a place to park. You hop into the backseat when you know it's nice and dark. You're just about to groove and you're thinking it's a breeze. A light in your eye and a guy says out of the car, long hamburger. You're coming with me, the local police. And it's all because your mama don't dance and your daddy don't rock and roll. Your mama don't dance and your daddy don't. Go to rock and roll. Where do you go to rock and roll? I said, where do you go? It was a pride and the passion of Dixie. Did exactly what her daddy had planned. She was a perfect little sister until somebody missed her and found her in the bushes with the boys in the band. But the Greeks don't want no freaks. I said the Greeks don't want no freaks. So put a big smile on those rosy cheeks, cause the Greeks don't want no freaks. I said the Greeks don't want no freaks. I said the Greeks don't want no freaks. Put a big smile on those rosy cheeks, cause the Greeks don't want no freaks. There was beer all over the dance floor, and the band was playing rhythm and blues. You got down and did the gator. A half an hour later, you were barfing all over your girlfriend's shoes. But the Greeks don't want no freaks. I said the Greeks don't want no freaks. So put a big smile on those rosy cheeks, cause the Greeks don't want no freaks. Gator! Pride and the passion of Dixie. She did exactly what her
her daddy had planned. She was a perfect little sister until somebody missed her and found her in the bushes with the boys in the band. But the Greeks don't want no freaks. I said the Greeks don't want no freaks. So put a monster smile on those rosy cheeks, 'cause the Greeks don't want no freaks. I said the Greeks don't want no freaks. I said the Greeks don't want no freaks. So put a great big smile on those rosy cheeks, 'cause the Greeks don't want no freaks. Greeks don't want no freaks. That's an Eagle song. Excuse me. Sorry, I scared the dog on that.
Worst, I guess you know the tune. Oh, somewhere a lost connection, ran out of songs to play. Came into town on a one-night stand, it looks like my plans fell through. Oh Lord, stuck in Lodi, Oregon. I'm voting in on a Greyhound, I'll be walking out if I go. I was only passing through, it must be 7 months or more. Ran out of time and money, it looks like they took my friends. Oh Lord, it's nothing you'll die again. Now if I only had a dollar for every song I sung, and every time I had to play with the people sad they drone, you know I'd catch the next train back where I live. Oh Lord, stuck in Lodi, Oregon. Oh Lord, stuck in Lodi, Oregon. Singing, oh Lord, stuck in Lodi again.
And from Lodi, we'll head to Kansas City. I'm going to Kansas City, Kansas City, here I come. I'm going to Kansas City, here I come. They got some pretty little women, man, this boy's gonna get them one. You'll find me standing on the corner, 12th Street and Vine. Standing on a corner, 12th Street and Vine, with a Kansas City lady drinking cheap rock and Kansas City wine. Well, I might take a train, I might catch a plane, if I gotta run, walk, crawl, or hitch, I'll get it just the same. I'm going to Kansas City, here I come. They got some pretty little women there, and this boy's gonna get them one. Kansas City men don't like me, 'cause they know I speak my mind. No, the Kansas City men don't like me, 'cause they know I speak my mind, yeah. But there's one or two ladies, they're crazy about me, 'cause I know how to take my time. Yeah, my daddy was no jockey, but he taught me how to ride. No, my daddy was no jockey, but he taught me how to ride, yeah. He said, you slide it on slow down in the middle, rock from side to side. Well, I might take a train, might catch a plane, if I gotta do a gosh darn boogaloo, I'll get there just the same. I'm going to Kansas City, here I come. They got some pretty little women there, boy's gonna get him one. A little Kansas City. Ah, my new neighbor. I'm going to call him Paul because I'll probably mess up his name. Welcome, neighbor. Welcome to the neighborhood. Glad you can join us tonight. I hope you're enjoying it. And I lost what song I was doing. Let's see. Oh, first things first. Welcome to the neighborhood. Salud. And I am going to play the next song. I'm going to do a song that I played this once and somebody, oh my gosh. I love that song. I love Guns N' Roses. So I let them say, okay. But it's actually a Dylan song. But you can sing any version that you'd like, so that's fine.
Mama, take this badge from me, 'cause I can't use it anymore. Getting dark, too dark to see. I feel like I'm knocking on heaven's door. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. Knocking on heaven's door. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. Mama, put these guns in the ground, 'cause I can't shoot them anymore. This long dark cloud is coming down. I feel like I'm knocking on heaven's door. Knock, knock, 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 knocking on heaven's door. Knocking on heaven's door. My voice is starting to crack a little bit. Excuse me, I'm just going to do a couple more songs and I think we'll call it a night then. But oh, I haven't had a Chianti in such a long time. And I used to drink Chianti all the time. I used to drink the Rufino Chianti in the black bottle, just the cheapy one. I loved it. My buddy Roy and I would drink that all the time. And then we just got away from it. And I haven't had a Chianti in so long. And I went to buy I ordered it for delivery. And I couldn't get the Rufino. It, like, everybody was sold out of it. So all of a sudden it's become a good wine. I don't know. So I ended up going with the straw. And it's okay because I got this straw one now, the straw bottle. I'm going to make a lamp out of it after I'm done. So that should probably be tomorrow. Make a lamp. So Let's see. What are we doing? Oh, I know. We're going to do a Jim Croce song.
Well, I just got out from the county prison doing 90 days for non-support. I tried to find me an executive position, but no matter how smooth I talk, they wouldn't listen to the fact that I was a genius. The man said, we got all of them we can use. And I got them steadily depressing, low-down mind missing, working at the car wash blues. Well, I should be smoking on with. Well, I should be sitting in a grip-man condition office with an easy.
I'm screwing this one up. I gotta start this one over.
Well, I should be sitting in an air-conditioned office in the gym.
Oh, Jesus, I can't believe it. Let's try this one more time, one more for this verse. I'm gonna take another sip. Edie said, that's the problem. That's the problem. You take another sip. I think I need to gargle with it. My voice, I'm so worried about cracking that I'm not concentrating on the words. Okay, let's... We'll start it all over again, folks.
Well, I just got out from the county prison doing 90 days for non-support. I tried to take an executive position, but no matter how smooth I talk, they wouldn't listen to the fact that I was a genius. The man said, we got all of them we can use. And I got them steadily depressing, low-down mind messing, working at the car wash blues. Well, I should be sitting in an air-conditioned office in a swivel chair, talking some trash to the secretary, saying, hey now, mama, come on over here. Instead, I'm stuck here rubbing these fence and a little rag and walking home in soggy old shoes. I got them steadily depressing, low-down mind messing, working at the car wash blues. Well, I get a bit of tea, should be smoking on a big cigar. Until I get myself straight, I guess I just have to wait in my rubber seat, rubbing these cars. Well, all you can do is shake your head. I guess you can't believe that it's true. And working at the scent of Niagara Falls is an undercover Howard Hughes. So baby, don't expect to see me with no double martini in any high-class society news. I got them steadily depressing, low-down mind messing, working at the car wash blues. I got them steadily depressing, low-down mind messing, working at the car wash blues.
Oh, sorry about that, folks. Boy, right in the middle of it. Actually, at the very beginning of it. Do I dare one more? One more. I'm trying to decide if it's worth it or not for you folks. Yeah, we'll give it a shot. I'm just going to give it a second. I've gargled with worse. I've gargled with wild turkey. I think I brushed my teeth with it too. But that was camping. All right.
On a long, lonely highway east of Omaha, you can listen to the engine moaning out at one long song. You can think about Omaha or the night you heard a night before. Well, your thoughts will soon be wandering, hey, they always do, when you're riding 16 hours.
nothing much to do, and you don't feel much like riding. You just wish the trip was through. Here I am on the road again. There I am up on the stage. Here I go playing the star again. There I go, turn the page. When you walk into a restaurant, strung out from the road, and you feel the eyes upon you as you're shaking off the cold, you pretend it doesn't bother you, and you just want to explode. Most times you can hear them talk, other times you can't. All the same old cliches on that woman or man. And you always see that number, you just cannot make a stand. Here I am, on the road again. There I am, up on the stage. Here I go, playing the star again. There I go, turn the page. Out there in the spotlight, you're a million miles away. Every ounce of energy you try to give away, as the sweat pours out your body, like the music that you play. Later in the evening, as you lie awake in bed, with the echoes from the amplifiers playing in your head, you smoke the day's last cigarette, remembering what she said. Here I am, on the road again. Here I am, up on the stage. There I go, playing the star again. There I go, turn the page. Here I am, on the road again. Here I am, up on the stage. There I go, playing the star again. There I go, there I go, turn the page.
Well, I think I'm going to call it a night, folks. I don't think I have another song left in me. My voice is starting to crack. I don't know where this came from, but it happens. Weather changes and everything else. But in any event, thank you again for joining us again for another. This is our 12th Quarantunes. It's not the 12th Friday. We figured that out today, but it's the 12th time I've done this. First night was just kind of a spur of the moment out in our yard for about 45 minutes. The time after that was for a little over an hour, and that was the following night in our basement. And then that was on a Monday. And then on a Friday, when we got actually started with Quarantunes, was that following Friday back in March. And we've been doing it every week. I made a promise to everybody that if you wanted it, I'd be here, and I'd keep trying to do it. As long as we're in quarantine, we're going to be doing this thing together. So thank you again for the support. Thank you for joining in. Thank you for the text messages and the Facebook messages and all your comments on this feed. I really enjoy reading everything afterwards. I don't get to really read it during, but I will read it right after this. Thank you again. I hope everybody has a great week. Please stay safe. Please keep wearing your masks out in public.
If you do need to go out, try not to, but if you need to, please try to stay safe. Use, you know, wash your hands, use hand sanitizer, wear a mask, and hold others accountable for that as well. It's the only way we're going to beat this thing and really get it right back to really being normal. And I can't believe how fast this time has gone. I know sometimes it feels like it's dragging, but it truly has gone a lot quicker than I expected. Next week is June. A couple days we're in June. So stay safe, stay healthy, stay smart, and we'll see you next week. We love you a lot. Take care.